Hello dear students, and once again welcome back to this online class video. This is the first part of the third chapter, how many squares, of class 5 subject mathematics. And before starting the video, I request to the all viewers to like, share and subscribe my channel. And I am Jay Prakash. Let's start the class. At first, let's have an overview of today's class. So today's class topics are: the first is introduction to square, the second is introduction to perimeter and area, and the third is measure stumps. Now come to the name of this chapter, that is square. How many square? So you all are very familiar this word, that what is a square in your previous classes. You have studied about it, and let me clear this word once again using this red box. So you can see that this red box has four sides, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, and you can see that all these four sides are equal, and it has also four angles, angle 1, 2, 3 and 4, and you can see that all angles are in the shape of L. It means these are right angles which are making 90 degree. So this is a perfect square. Now we can define this, that what is a square. So a square is a shape which has four equal sides with four equal angles. Now I think there is no doubt with this word. Now come to the question. Measure the side of the red square on the dotted sheet. Draw here as many rectangles as possible using 12 such square. So two tasks is given in this one question. First we have to measure the length of this red box. I think it may be 1 centimeter, or it may be 2 centimeter. Okay, you can check it by using ruler. Okay, and now second is, we have to make a rectangle, one rectangle using 12 square. How can you make it? Let's try to make it. So first we have to make a square like this red box. Okay, means if you will join four dots, okay, so you will get one square, right? Similarly, you have to make 12 squares by joining the sides of one by one all squares. So let me take the first one I have taken. Now more 11 I have to make. So this is the second, this is the third, and now 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. So you can see that the squares are made, but the lines are not straight. So to make straight lines, you can use your ruler. Okay, now another square for rectangle we are going to make. So now we will take a pair of three squares, 3 and 4, to make a rectangle. So first I have taken from here, okay, this first box, then this is the second, and this is the third. So in one vertical line I am taking three is squares. Okay, similarly you can take from left to right four squares. So 1, 2, this is the 3 and this is the 4. Similarly you can join this all dots. So finally you can see that we have taken 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So with 12 squares we have made a rectangle. Okay, and this is the first rectangle, it is our second rectangle. In this way you can make many rectangles. Was it interesting? Yes, very interesting. Now how many rectangles could you make? So we could make only 2 rectangles. You can make more than 2. Now here is a 1. So this type of rectangle you can also make using a square box. Now each rectangle is made out of 12 equal squares. Yes, so all have the same area. Yes, definitely, but the length of the boundary will be different. So what do you mean by the length of the boundary? Yes, it is perimeter. Here you can see length of the boundary is called perimeter. Let me clear this word. For example, here you can see this rectangle which is made using 12 squares. So this boundary, okay, this black boundary, you can see this is the perimeter. Okay, this thing is known as the perimeter of this shape. Clear? Means the outer length of a shape is known as its perimeter. Clear? Now another word is here, area. That what is an area? Confused? Actually, the area is the occupied space by a flat shape. For example, let me clear. You can see here that one red box is here, okay, and it is completely filled, as you can see. So this filled space is its occupied space. Okay, so this occupied space will be its area. Clear? Or in another way, you can say that the amount, okay, this amount of space inside boundary of a flat object such as a rectangle, circle, square is known as its area. Okay, so we have given two definition of area. I think you have understand very well. Okay, now come to the next question. Which of these rectangles has the longest perimeter? We have to find the longest perimeter from that two. And which of this rectangle has the smallest perimeter? Okay, now once again we have to make that rectangles, the two rectangles that we drawn here. So let me help you. So this is the first, then second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11 and 12. Come on my dear students, help me to make a rectangle using 12 squares. So here is your first rectangle. Okay, now let me make the second rectangle. So by using the another color, I am taking the black one. So first, second, third, as you can see here that I am taking black color for the second rectangle. Okay, so 1, 2, 3 and this is the fourth. So join the all dots. Okay, so we have our two different type of rectangles. So now you will tell me that which rectangle, okay, this is the rectangle 1 and this is the rectangle 2. So which rectangle has the more perimeter? Can you answer? So to find the perimeter, you have to check the length of this shape. Okay, so as I told you that if you will measure this red box length, okay, so you will find that its length is 1 centimeter. Okay, one side is 1 centimeter. So you will see that here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. So it means it is 12 centimeter. Okay, and the breadth is only 1 centimeter. Its another length will be also 12 and breadth will be 1 centimeter. So how much is the perimeter? Just to find the perimeter, you have to add this all sides. So 12 plus 1 13, 13 plus 12 25 plus 1 26. So you found the perimeter of the first rectangle is 26 centimeter. Now similarly you have to find the perimeter of the second rectangle. Okay, so the length is of the one box is 1 centimeter one side, then it is 2, 3, means the breadth is 3 and the length is 4, because it has 1, 2, 3 and 4 sides. Okay, so its opposite sides are equal. So 4 and 4, it will be 8, and 8 plus 3, 11, 11 plus 3, 14. Okay, so it has 14 centimeter. Okay, let me clear this once again. The lengths are 4, 4 centimeter and the breadths are 3 and 3 centimeter. So 3 and 3 6, 6 plus 4 10, 10 plus 4 14. So the perimeter of the second rectangle is 14 centimeter, and the perimeter of the first rectangle was 26 centimeter. Now you can easily say to me that the first perimeter, sorry, the first rectangle has the more perimeter. Okay, now can you tell me what is the area, means which has bigger area? Actually they both have same area, How can you say? Actually, the formula to find the area of rectangle is length into breadth. Remember that? What is the formula? That is length into breadth. Okay? Means you have to simply multiply the length and the breadth. So 12 vanja, it is 12 square centimeter. Okay? Square centimeter. Similarly, here you can find for the second rectangle, you have to multiply the length, which is 4, and the breadth is 3. So 4 3 is 12. It is also 12 square centimeter. Okay, so their area is same, but perimeter is not same. Okay, so the first rectangle has more perimeter. Wow, it was a very lengthy calculation. Now come to the next question. So in this page number 34, you have understand about perimeter, area, and how to find perimeter and area.